Everybody, it's Lily Willy. I'm not certain how many more videos I have in me about this Charlottesville thing. I might have a few, not certain yet. But tonight I want to talk openly about some things. What happened? What happened in Charlottesville was a lot of things. Pathetic. Horrible. Tremendously painful. And that's just a start. We had a young woman who was killed when she joined those who were opposing a mixed group of white supremacists. This is beyond bad. And white supremacism, ethnic supremacism of any sort, is beyond pissy. The mentality is what is barely worth pissing on. But that mentality doth not exist only in white supremacists. It might take different forms. It might not always be about skin color or ethnic background in those who have the thinking pattern that is at the core of ethnic supremacism of any sort, including white supremacism, as well as anti-group prejudice. And that is the demeaning of a whole group in the person's sight or in the group's sight. It is reducing people with feelings, thoughts, life histories, whole groups of individuals with life histories, with fears just like you, who laugh, who cry, who worry, who have in some cases, been through many little hells and back, and sometimes a few big ones from which they're trying to come back, or maybe they have come back, but they haven't called all of them back. And they're angry. Anger is an understandable response even though it's one I don't condone with me or others, to a stressor that the person who is angry wants to fight. It's the fight part of the fight-flight mechanism in the mammalian brain. And in hominids, reasons for which an individual might feel angered have so many shitloads of complex reasons from the birth of the first hominid onward that one could not, probably not begin to document all of them. But psychology has tried a few. Good luck, psychologists. You have years worth of, few millennia worth of work ahead of you if you really want to document all of it. But here's the thing. Everybody involved in this attack is a hominid being, amongst those who are most directly involved, both those who attacked which in regard to the car was Mr. Fields, James Alex Fields. We have a group or two of white supremacists who formally gathered, and we have a group of counter protesters . I support those who seek to counter hatred from a place of peace. Peace with strength and true nonviolence. But for me, real nonviolence would mean non-angry behavior. And it's a type of nonviolence I haven't mastered. And I have yet to hear that anybody involved on either side showed it. Either. I don't know. What concerns me deeply about this is now that everybody has had a few days to start wrestling with themselves and others about what happened. Coming to grips wherever they might be and whatever they're feeling with their pain, their anger, their fear, their terror, and their worries in relation to this incident. And what it means, and what it will mean for the United States, for everyday people. For Heather's family. For her colleagues. And for the colleagues of those, the colleagues and family of those who gathered in support of violent white supremacist activity on this occasion. To be quite open with you, the behavior of everybody around this, almost everybody other than one or two really sane people with whom I've talked about this, is effing scaring me. Counter bigotry isn't going to work. The white supremacists involved did something and were involved in something horrible. There is nobody sane who is countering that. Nobody. And maybe they should all be rounded up and put in jail for a decade or two. Then given whatever prescription medications they might need and therapy. Mandatory therapy. For dealing with healing any issues that may have helped lead up to their behavior, whatever it might be, neurological, psychological, emotional, social, economic. We don't know. And that's the point. I will overtly and do stand pro peace and pro gentleness with strength. And I'm doing my best for to do it against my own anger and against anger in all forms, including kinetic violence and verbal violence towards anybody. I'm still working on it. I blew up at my computer several times today and got annoyed with my body for a little ding-a-ling shit. So I'm still working on it. But I will do whatever any given moment is in my ability for to do. To be water to fire. A peaceful and solid stone in opposition to angry metal. I have no idea how well I'll wind up doing as I go along, but I'm bloody well gonna do my best. I've known a lot of people in my time. When I was little, I was too young. And in certain ways, too disabled to really have had much real opportunity or ability to get involved in some of the gang activity that in my neighborhood at the time, theoretically, I could have gotten involved in. In my neighborhood, then, in the 80s and in the very early 90s, there were skinheads. I knew two people who were involved in them. They were both teens when I was very little. They got better. They both got much better. I will not go into many details. I will say that both of them, in different ways, are now very good people. One of them is married in everything but the law to someone who is also involved in them in her turbulent teens, and she's also now a very wonderful woman. Nobody. A group is not a group without many individuals in it. You don't know the history of all the individuals who were involved. You don't know fellow liberals. How many of those people who were involved in violence in that incident had it around them growing up? You don't know how many of them had seen or lived through abuse. You don't know how many of them already had existing psychological conditions that made it much less probable that they'd be able to keep themselves from wrestling themselves to stay away from that event. I'm not trying to say what they did was okay. It wasn't. And the whole philosophy of ethnic supremacism in any of its forms, or religious supremacism, true supremacism in any of its forms, is not even worth my piss or yours. But anybody who wants a more peaceful world, a less violent world, a less angry world, a less hate-filled world, a less militant world, should be ashamed of themselves. If they are advocating violence towards the neo-Nazis involved for any reason other than in the immediate moment self-defense, if it turned up, they should be ashamed of themselves . And you know what? If you drive these skinheads, the neo-Nazis out of your town, if everybody did that, guess what it'll do? It would make those neo-Nazis more angry. And it could cause more violence. Is that what you want? Round them up if you have to. Round them up. Dox them if you must, but don't box them. Not all individuals, even with any group, even a white supremacist group, fit into the same box. They're individuals. They all have their own history. You need to do what you can. To round these people up who were involved in the violent interactions and put them away. Long enough for them to have the chance to calm down, to heal from what they did to themselves and to their society, and to Heather Heyer, and to this country, to have the chance to settle down, calm down, maybe get treated for whatever problems they've got. They might even have to be mandatorily treated. In some cases. Keep them away from society for 20 or 30 years if you have to, that's fine. But don't you dare just say drive them out without trying to create a real solution. To the attitudes, the anger, the group hatred in yourselves. Whether it's towards the Republicans, towards the leftists, towards the terrorists, towards the whatevers. If your thoughts are directing anger towards a whole group on a regular basis, you're part of the problem that led to this type of group. At the level of energy, at the level of thought, at the level of feeling, irrespective of the face, the cause face it might wear, if you're putting anger towards a whole group of mixed individuals and hatred of whole mixed groups of individuals on an active basis with your thoughts, your feelings, your words, and your kinetic actions, then you are part of the problem. If you want peace, do what you can, moment to moment, to become more peaceful, to think more peace, to think more kindness. To think more non-harm. And do it while doing whatever it is you do. You might not be able to always do the same things each time, and that's okay. My husband had only once or twice really seen me flip my lid on him. Because I know of my anger problem, and I've been working to clear myself of it. It's one I grew up with. And was enhanced by things I went through. And he and I had this conversation once in the middle of 2016, I think. He was seated on the couch. I was seated on a chair. And I told him right then, as we had been having an argument, and I told him right then, love, I love you very much, and I won't do this, but I really feel like pounding your face in right now. And I did not do it. He and I talked for a couple of minutes. And that was that. We kind of he either went to take a few minutes for himself, and then we went to do something, or we talked and he and I went somewhere together that night. This world, and neither of us raised a fist against the other, or a slap it wound up okay. And we're still married to each other. But he... So as you can see, I still actually do have an anger problem. My brain does. Even when I don't behave on it. It's something I've been cleansing myself from, bit by bit. This whole world had the horrific millennia-long anger problem. At its core, every anti-group has at its core either anger or fear. As the seed, the inspiration seed, fueling their issue, whether it's because they're afraid of being eradicated, fear of losing their jobs, fear of non-survival, fear of foreigners, fear of another religion, fear of another nationality. Almost all the groups that embrace violence, including verbal violence, against another group, irrespective of their political orientation. All of them that seek to address a problem like white supremacism and like most of the problems that we're facing in the United States and in the world today, who seek to do it from a place of anger are part of the problem if what they want is peace and nonviolence. And healing from militants. If you want to solve this problem, white supremacism, look at what problems the people who were involved in this attack were having, and look at how many of the white supremacists across the world may be having some of those problems too. May find economics is involved. I'm not sure. Please. I'm not telling you to seek out your local neo-Nazis and offer a hug. But just trying to drive them out of your town isn't going to do it. It'll lead to more violence in the long run. Because the anger from it will fuel more. Eventually, if not in your town, or the next one, then the next one, or the next state. Or across the border. The short-term solutions like that, like the ostracization, are not real solutions for this one. Please. Please. Think about it. Think about it. Talk about it. With each other. Because what you're dealing with is people. And letting yourself look at them as less than human, or as trash, or as any of that other stuff, that it can sometimes feel really good for people to reduce groups to better help themselves not care. There are those amongst my relatives whose relation to me I will not name, whom I internally think of as scum of a sort, but I still care about them. I care about them altruistically. I would still reach out my hand if they were in danger, and not just because they're related to me. I would do that with someone who was not genetically or socially related to me. For being an existing being who was in danger, to the best of my ability in the moment. I'm not perfect in the botched sense that this damn world has so often defined perfect. In the most recent centuries, I'm not even perfect, totally, in the sense ancient Greeks meant, because I'm not whole. There are some qualities which I don't want in myself, in my future me. So I will never be. In that most literal sense, perfect. And I don't even believe that God is flawless. But I will tell you this. what I've been seeing, including on the lips of my fellow liberals, have been securing me. And it hurts. I understand that we're hurting. And people who cannot conceive of ourselves going so off the wall that we would drive a car on purpose from malice. I assume it was from malice into a whole group. People only because we disagreed with them. I hurt. And then some. And then some more. I get this. And what the people in Charlottesville, Virginia are dealing with right now. But we have to. Those who want a more peaceful planet, a more peaceful world, a more peaceful United States, a more peaceful anywhere, have to. Have to. Stop focusing so much anger on angry methods as political tools or social tools. Because in the long run, they will destroy everybody. When the right people do it. It's not good. And we have to, amongst those who want a more peaceful and less violent world, have to do what we can to not contribute in how we think and what we say and what we kinetically communicate. Kinetically communicate. To anger. Because anger is violence in the brain. And it hurts. Ultimately, it hurts. You want peace. Anger is not the right tool. Only if you don't. If you're focused on something that isn't peace. Then for you there might be more room for it, but for me there isn't. Let there be peace. Amen. Blessed be.